You know, you've heard me use the phrase one step further many times on this show. It reflects people who are pushing the limits to achieve their goals. And my next guest is no exception. He's a 25-year-old athlete who doesn't take no for an answer. He triumphed against the odds to take steps no one thought he could. Take a look.
Blake Leeper, like so many young boys, grew up dreaming of being a star athlete. The one thing that made him different, he was born without legs below his knees. But Blake has never been one for excuses. Throughout his childhood, he played several sports and was even on his high school's varsity basketball team. In 2009, he received his first pair of running prosthetics and has been unstoppable ever since. He's won countless awards, including the silver and bronze medals at the 2012 Paralympic Games. Now Blake has his eyes set on the 2016 Olympics, where he plans to be the first disabled American athlete to compete in the games. And nothing can slow him down.
Woo! Please welcome Blake Leeper!
It's a couple of them. Yeah.
Can I hold them for one second?
Yeah, of course you can. Yeah.
This is heavy.
It is.
This is heavy.
Yeah,
have a seat.
Thank you so much. Yeah. People don't realize how heavy they are until they actually put them on or weigh them out. So it's a good workout when I'm
like, I was about to say, man, you can work out with this.
Yeah, that's how I stay so strong sometimes. Yeah,
it's great. Yeah. Let me give you all that weight to hold. You the one in shape.
I'll put these right here.
First of all, I have to say congratulations for everything. Thank you so much for being here. And I got to just talk about your smile. Every time I see you, your smile is just so infectious, your positive attitude. Where does that come from?
Yeah, you know, at the end of the day, I'm just happy just to be alive. Every day, you put your shoes on one shoe at a time. I put my legs on one leg at a time. And it's just the same thing. You know, one of my favorite quotes is from Coach Lou Holtz. Life is 10% of what you're dealt with and 90% on how you deal with it. And I'm a true believer in that.
You know, it's funny because while I was preparing to interview you for the show, mm-hmm. just doing some homework on you, I was so inspired by everything you were saying. I'm like, I have to have Blake Leeper quotes around my dressing room, in my car. There's so many positive things that you have to say. That, you know, people are complaining about stuff all the time. And here you are, when is the book coming out?
Yeah, it's on its way.
It's on its way.
Yeah, yeah,
need
looking
for a
little.
You gonna come back here and talk about it?
Yeah, if you help me write it, that's the only thing. Yeah, and they'll say if you help me write it,
you need a forward.
Yeah, just a little bit. Yeah,
I got you covered. No problem. Hey, listen, being a kid is hard for everyone growing up. How was it hard for you?
I mean, it was tough. You know, some days I'd wake up, you know, and question, like, why me? You know, I can remember times playing T-ball, and I would run around the bases, and my leg would just fall off, and I'd be tagged out. And, you know, at times I felt like I, you know, let my father down and myself down and my teammates down. And I could ask myself, like, why me? Why is this happening to me? Everybody else is born with legs. All the kids are having fun. Now you're telling me that I have to deal with my situation. But as I got older and more situations that I dealt with in my life, I realized instead of asking why me, ask yourself, well, why not me? I'm meant for this. Well, why not me? I'm strong enough for this. I'm a true believer that everything that we go through in our life is for a reason, and it makes us stronger for the next mission. So, to let you know.